Welcome to Looking at the Markets with David Modell. Today I wanted to talk to you about the yield curve. What is the bond yield curve? Why is it important to know about it? Can it predict a market crash or economic recession? And where do we stand now with the yield curve? All right, so yield curve, what is it? It's also called the term spread. It is the difference between long-term bond yields and short-term bond yields. Specifically, it usually refers to the 10-year bond yield minus the 2-year bond yield. In a fairly normal and healthy economic situation, 10-year bond yields should pay more than 2-year bond yields. After all, a 10-year commitment should yield more or pay more than just a 2-year commitment. That makes sense. Also, if strong economic growth is expected in the coming years, then higher inflation is to be expected because prices will rise. Therefore, the 10-year bonds ought to have a higher yield, they ought to pay more, in order to compensate for the expected inflation. But when the market doesn't expect the economy to do well and doesn't expect inflation to increase, 10-year bond yields can remain stubbornly low, like they are right now. Meanwhile, if the Federal Reserve keeps on raising short-term bond yields, which they've been doing, there can be a narrowing between the 10-year and the 2-year bond yields. They can get closer together. The next thing you know, we can find ourselves in a bizarre situation in which 10-year and 2-year bond yields are the same. This is known as a flattened yield curve. So when the 10-year and 2-year bonds pay the same amount, the same percentages, that's a flattened yield curve. Then it can get even more bizarre. We can have a situation in which 2-year bond yields are even higher or greater than 10-year bond yields. And this is known as an inverted yield curve. So let's take a look, and I want to give credit for this graphic here. It's from bankrate.com. All right, so here are some examples of yield curves. All right, so this is a normal one, the light blue line. All right, so let's take a look at the 2-year. If the 2-year treasury notes or bonds, U.S. government bonds, yield, if the 2-year ones yield this much and the 10-year ones yield this much, which is much higher, well, that's normal. The 10-year ones should yield a lot more than the 2-year ones, right? That makes sense. So that's a normal yield curve. It should go upwards at a normal pace. Sometimes you'll get a steeply sloped yield curve. You don't want it to be too steep, but this can happen. But it gets bizarre when the line flattens out, like the red one here. When the 2-year bonds pay just as much as the 10-year bonds, that's not how it should be. That just doesn't make sense. And then when the yield curve, like the green line here, actually inverts, then you've got the 2-year bonds paying even more than the 10-year and 20-year and 30-year sometimes even. When the 2-year bonds pay more than the 10-year bonds, that's very strange, and it should not be like that. It's not a good sign in most cases. Think about how strange it is for a short-term bond to pay more than a long-term bond. It doesn't really make sense, and it shouldn't be like that. But it's more than just strange. It's also surprisingly accurate. It's a surprisingly accurate predictor of economic recessions. Talking about inverted yield curves are an accurate, at least in the past, they've been an accurate predictor of economic recessions, at least according to the San Francisco Fed. Let's see what they have to say about it. The term spread, or the difference between long-term and short-term interest rates, is a strikingly accurate predictor of future economic activity. Every U.S. recession in the past 60 years was preceded by a negative term spread, or in other words, an inverted yield curve. Furthermore, a negative term spread was always followed by an economic slowdown and, except for one time, one exception, was followed by a recession. Let's see what that looks like. And this is also from the Fed. same source, the San Francisco Fed, Federal Reserve. Let's take a look at that. So the gray bars here, gray columns, are recessions throughout the years in the United States. And this blue line represents the difference in percentage points between the 10-year and the 2-year bond yields. And we can see when it dips, when it gets down to zero, it's a flattened yield curve, which is strange. And then when you get below, when it gets into negative territory, then it's the really strange situation of the inverted yield curve. It happened here, and right after that, recession. Happened here, recession right after. Here's the exception they were referring to. It happened here, no recession. Now, this was many years ago. So, yes, there was an exception a long, long time ago. But look at right after that. It went into negative territory, recession right afterwards. Negative, recession. Negative, here's a recession. Soon after, negative again, and recession. Negative, recession, negative, recession, negative, recession. And here's where we're heading now. And it's getting to, actually, the blue line is right now closer as of this video, the recording. This blue line is very, very close to flat and negative. And I'll show you that momentarily. So here we are. Where are we now? Again, we can look to the San Francisco Fed for our data. And here's where we are, right here. This is zero. Underneath is negative, and look how far, look how close we've gotten to zero, to flattened and inverted. Currently, as of July 23rd, 2018, which is when I'm making this video, the difference between the 10-year and 2-year bond yields is a mere 0.29%, almost at the point of becoming flattened or inverted. So what's my point? Well, if you're 100% long U.S. equities, stocks in other words, you might consider lightening up your position and allocating some capital towards precious metals and other commodities, currencies, cryptocurrencies, and or other holdings that are not strongly correlated to the equities markets. In other words, I definitely hope you're protecting your assets. I hope this makes you think. I'm here to make you think. You have to make your own decisions. I know what I'm doing. Do you know what you're doing? My name's David Modell. This is Looking at the Markets. If you like this video, if you found it important, please give it a thumbs up on YouTube. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that bell on YouTube so you can get more updates like this on the financial activity and on the markets. I do help people put together trading and investing plans so you can protect yourself. You can email me anytime. My email address is davidmodell@gmail.com. And also, you can ask me about my stock signal or alerts service, which I also offer. All right, thanks a lot. I appreciate it. Please take this warning to heart. It's important. All right, I'll talk to you again soon. Thanks a lot.